Since the economic crisis hit Greece, the country has drawn a lot of attention from all over Europe, and even more since Syriza took the leadership alongside with a hard criticism on its negotiation actions and political behavior. Mr. George Katrugalos, the Deputy Minister of Internal and Administrative Reconstruction of the country, but also a personality that recently has been accused for corruption, answers on all kind of criticism. Reporting from Athens, for Brussels and Aktua TV, Haragioka.
So as I can understand it, it is more that Syriza wants to rediscuss the amount of the debt, not actually demand to cut or erase the debt.
No. Have in mind that it is not an issue for the negotiations we have with our partners, the issue of the writing of the debt till June. Because what we are trying to achieve within this period of, let's say, 4 months, already less than that, we have made an agreement with our partners on the 20th of February that has as basic characteristic that gives us the political space and time to implement our program without having resolved all these pending issues.
Which is that program?
What we are planning to do within this small period of time. It is to face the humanitarian crisis and to redress the situation with some immediate measures, as it is food to the people that do not have food, electric to the people that are out, they have not such electric connections.
How?
At their shelters. We have already passed this legislation.
Mm-hmm.
And on the second hand, in a way, returning back to what constitutes the European social model. For instance, during the period of memoranda, we had an abrogation of the collective negotiations in the private sector. This is completely against what constitutes the European tradition in handling issues like that in the labor law. In the public sector, the same. We had a huge reduction of the personnel in the administration by one third, and now it is not possible for the civil service to cover basic social functions, health, education. Yeah. So we want to go back to what is the European social model, and this is not something extremely radical. This should be considered to be the basic for a country of the European Union.
Okay, everything now, despite Mr. Tsipras' intention for an honorable compromise, seems to be directed in a conflict between Greece, to put it very broadly, between Greece and its European partners.
I have the feeling that the two parts want to have a honorable compromise, because nobody is going to win if we arrive finally at a conflict, at a clash. It is obvious that we want a solution within the European Union.
From now, from this day, will Greece be directed to try having an honorable compromise, as Mr. Tsipras has said?
Of course.
Or will be in a conflict with its European partners?
Who is going to win if a conflict occurs? Nobody. Not us, not Greece, but neither the European Union, because nobody is going to be able to stop the negative consequences of such a clash.
Mm-hmm.
And exactly because the conflict is a lose-lose situation, whereas a honorable compromise is a win-win situation,
so
I'm very optimistic that we are going to have this win-win final result.
So you are saying that Greece is directed to compromise?
Greece is directed to a compromise.
And had already signed the deal.
Which is going to respect our essential political options, that is against austerity and for a social handling of the crisis, and at the same time, the demands of our partners.
Till May, will Greece have money to pay salaries in the public sector, pensions, and the suppliers so they can pay their staff?
We have money to pay back what we owe. The problem, I repeat, is not that. Is that we must put the economy back at its feet.
Of course.
The recovery of the economy. And this is not possible when we have to schedule week by week. That's why we are expecting by our European partners to respect their obligations. We are expecting from the European Central Bank to respect its mandate and to assure the liquidity that we need in order to put the economy back.
You said that Greece has money to pay the debt?
We have found till now, by national means, all the necessary money to fund the debt.
And I'm why is not getting paid?
It is getting paid.
It is getting paid?
Of course it is getting paid.
Okay. You're also being accused recently to be implicated in a scandal involving private contracts signed by you with workers in the public sector mm-hmm. as an exchange of 12% from their compensation.
Mm-hmm. That's exactly what
is that
is
true?
What I am referring about. Of course, it is not true.
You was a lawyer before your occupation now, before your position now.
Before being
you was a lawyer, and that was a part of your job. So there's no any scandal here.
Before being
but
a politician,
you're
I was
being
a lawyer.
Accused exactly that. But you're being accused that you have dropped your previous occupation, and you kept working like that. Having as an exchange that 12% of the comparison.
That is clear that these contracts are not related to anything I have done after being nominated minister. They have been part of my professional life when I was a lawyer. So it is a very clear example of this smear campaign that what constitutes for me a title of honor that I had a very stable and continuous political opinions, there has been an effort to turn it against me.
That incident was broadcasted in media that since you stopped being a lawyer anymore, you kept signing contracts.
That's exactly the
last You kept
that,
signing that, contracts that promising
exactly,
people
exactly,
that they are going to
exactly.
work in the public sector.
This is
and you
clear,
were that, you was taking a small percentage
but
on
I,
that.
I'm explaining to you that that was exactly the lie. And that's why now this lie is not anymore mm-hmm. reproduced by the media. And all those that they have been accused
me, yeah.
they are now under juridical investigation, and they're going to pay for that in the process I have in June. So as I told you, I said before, now all this war of information is based exactly on this, let's say, fear of the vested interests of the Greek oligarchs that
who are those Greek oligarchs?
I described to you before this entanglement of private and public interests of mass media owners, of people that have never paid during the crisis. I must bring you into your attention a report of the budget office of the parliament last year when we were not in power that has a very extraordinary let's say finding that the Greek rich people have not become poorer during the crisis, but on the contrary, richer. So what we are trying to achieve through our policies is exactly to restore social justice, to make the Greek rich people to pay as all the other Greeks have paid. And exactly for this reason, we have this reaction on behalf of the vested interests of these oligarchs, of what we called in Greece the entanglement, the aploki.
This is an aspect of a social inequality that caused social crisis in Greece, not only economic crisis.
And not only, it is not all, first of all, we must be clear, it is the neoliberal agenda throughout Europe that creates this rise of inequalities. In addition to that, we have in Greece an additional phenomenon that these vested interests are not gaining their money by their productive entrepreneurship, but exactly by gaining political money through the state. We are going to face both situations, that is, the reversal of the neoliberal agenda, but at the same time, the necessity to have a saner political system, a political system that it is not related to illegal relations between the magnates of the money and the political representatives of established political families, owners of mass media, etc. We have been the only state in Europe that had the possibility to requisition in the military strikers. When a strike was not considered to be pleasant for the government, it had the possibility not only to go to the courts and demand that this strike is going to be declared illegal, of course this is an option everywhere in Europe, it had the possibility to requisition to the military the strikers. Of course this goes back to dictatorial tactics, and it is not something we can tolerate within a democracy. We started by the abolition of this practice. Then, another thing important to do, it is to restore good relationships within the public service. The previous administration considered the public servants as a kind of, let's say, internal enemies. And it has imposed a very particular disciplinary law that put out of service every public servant who was accused for a disciplinary fault.
My apologies.
Just imagine, without any evidence, just if somebody was accusing you, you would be automatically put out of the service. And a lot of this practice has been used against people that had just a typical syndicalist activity.
Now, if it's possible, I need two, three policies that are about to be done in the next two, three months.
A second measure we have now put into the law, mm-hmm. it's a new mobility scheme. The problem of the Greek administration was never that it was big. If you look at the statistics, even in 2010, we have been at the European average, both with what regard regards the number of the public servants and the public expenses. What is the problem of the Greek administration? The irrational allocation of personnel, exactly because of the clientelist policies. That's why we have now provided for a mobility scheme that facilitates the transfer from public servants from posts that are not so in need of them to other posts that urgently have need of personnel, such as the health, the education, the controlling mechanisms.
Thank you very much for your time.
No, it was a pleasure.